Let's get some donations up out here, man. Let's get some donations in the room, man, for my time and energy. And go ahead and like and share this, man. Because I got some treats for you. I'm going to show you how I affect the Blue D bill of exchange, and it works for me every time towards the end of this presentation. Now in the 1930s, but you need this history to understand why this stuff is essential. Understand that. Now in the 1930s, the federal legislation provided for registration of babies through the application for birth certificates. So government workers could get maternity leave with pay. That's the reason it came forth with the registration for the birth certificate. The states pushed for registration of cars. Prior to that, you didn't have to register no damn car, man. I bought this car as mine. There's no trust. I had the allodial title to my home, and I had the manufacturer's statement of origin, the MSL, to my car. So I own it. I didn't have to pay no property taxes. This is how people got duped, man, and they don't know this history. So the states push for registration of cars through applications for certificates of title. Certificate of title, no longer the manufacturer's statement of origin. And for land through registration of deeds of trust. Man, what the hell are you doing giving me a deed of trust, man? Where's my allodial title? They took it all away from you. And you sit around and you listen to these people that come on the internet that push you this garbage that get you in trouble a few weeks, a few months later. They don't understand this stuff. They're trying to give you some shortcuts. Then you get hit with reversals because you can't thoroughly explain this because you don't want to take the time to learn it correctly. You got to burn the midnight oil and really learn this stuff, man. So what's going on here? Constructive trust secretly were created as each of the people blindly walked into the United States democracy, thereby consenting to the securities for the debts of the United States. Into the Great Depression. The Great Depression supplied the diversion to keep the people attention off what the government was really doing. The Social Security program was implemented along with numerous other United States programs that invited the American people to volunteer to be sureties behind the United States' new registered property and adhesion contracts. Tazadaq, what is an adhesion contract? I haven't been listening to you. I've been listening to these other guys, and they've taught me to suffer from aphasia. What is an adhesion contract? An adhesion contract means everything is not revealed. It's not openly revealed. An adhesion contract is not really binding. I could come back and overturn an adhesion contract because it's not full disclosure. See, one of the principles of a valid contract is full disclosure. Adhesion contracts don't contain full disclosure. The only reason they're effective is because you consent. But if I could go back and prove that was in full disclosure, I could overturn that. Do you understand? Do you understand? Adhesion contracts. So the Social Security program was implemented along with numerous other United States programs that invited the American people to volunteer to be sureties. If you're a surety, that means you're responsible. Proverbs, he that surety for a stranger shall smart for it, meaning you should suffer for it. He that is surety, you stop making yourself a surety for a debtor. So you made yourself surety for the United States. The plan was well and on its path in 1933. Massive registration of property through United States agencies, including the state of New York, the state of California, the state of Pennsylvania subdivisions, assured that the United States and its officers would become rich beyond their wildest expectations, just like Edward Mandel House stated, as predicted by Mandel House. All of this was done without disclosure, and he's in contract of the material facts that accompany each application for registration. See? This was sufficient. This was efficient reason to charge all United States officers unless they gave a remedy. See, if they didn't give a remedy, it would be considered fraud. But if they gave a remedy, you can't call it fraud. You got these patriots out here calling it fraud. It's not fraud because they gave you a remedy. Well, they gave you a remedy for the damages that they may have caused. So if a remedy was available and the people failed to use the remedy, then no charge of fraud can be substantiated. It can't be sustained. Even in the common law court, you can't sustain a charge if there's a remedy. The United States only needed to provide the remedy. It was not required to explain to the people or even tell them that the remedy could be found if you look. So the attorneys did not even have to be taught about the remedy. Only the higher echelon knows about the remedy. That's why some attorney, what are you talking about, man? It's frivolous. So what does it go back to? It goes back to what House told them that gave them plausible deniability when the people struggled to understand the new laws. The legislators did not have to have the intricate details of the law explained to them regarding the bills they were passing. So that gave them plausible deniability. So if the people failed to use their remedy, the United States came out the winner every time. If the people did not discover the remedy, the United States had to honor it if they did. But if the people did not discover it, then the United States came out the winner. Huh? But if the people did discover the remedy, the United States had to honor it and release the registered property back to the people, but only if the people knew they had a remedy. And only if they requested it in the proper manner. It's a great plan. What is the manner to request this? Secure party creditor. UCC-1 filing, from my perspective. Huh? This is my opinion. You don't have to believe it. See, with plausible deniability, even when the people knew they had a remedy and pursued it, the attorney, the briefcases, the robes, the legislators could act as though, you don't know what you're talking about, man. It's frivolous documents you're filing here. They could deny the people's claims. Requiring the public schools to teach the civics government, the history classes, out of approved political correct textbooks, and assured that the people would not find the remedy. So in other words, they made sure this wasn't taught in schools. Passing new state and federal laws that appeared to subject the people to rules and regulations added another level of protection against the people funding, or should I say finding, their remedy. The public media was molded to report political correct through substantially incorrect news day after day, until few people would even think there could be a remedy. So what does the people think? Well, I know something's wrong. I just don't know what. They don't know that there's a remedy available to them. And then you get people that's coming around, oh man, this secure party credit is garbage. They're doing it, it's preventing you from getting your remedy. So the people could be separated from their money and their time to pursue the remedy long enough for the solution to be lost in the pages of millions and millions and millions of books in huge law libraries across the country. So many people knew there's something wrong with all the conflict and the last laws, with the facts taught in school. Do they not respect persons? And those who have enacted the people to register their property with the United States and its subdivisions have gained control over the people's substance through their registrations. The United States became the holder of the titles to many things, like your sons and your daughters, by way of the birth certificate. The definition of property, watch this. The definition of property is the entrance one have in a thing. The thing is the principle. The property is the entrance in the thing. The deceivers profited by property of another belonging to the owner of the thing. The deceivers profited by pledging the registered property in commercial markets. But the profits do not belong to the deceivers. The profits belong to the owner of the things. That is always the people. So the corporations only show ownership of paper, titles to things. The substance cannot appear in the fiction. I tell you what, man. Y'all go and watch that old movie, The Last Action Hero. Huh? The Last Action Hero. And watch the confusion created when they try to mix substance and fiction. Now, sometimes the fiction is made to look very much like the substance. But the fiction can never become substance. It's an impossibility. Now, there are, in essence, two issues. The first issue, which creates presumptions of a constructed trust, is that the gold was removed from the people by mandate of the law of Franklin Delano Roosevelt. So when the people did not receive full and adequate consideration for the gold that was given away, a constructive trust was literally created wherein the party that received the gold, i.e. the United States Corporation, now held the duty to pay the debts of the people, since the people no longer held any money with to pay the debt. So their goal or substance had been exchanged for non-redeemable Federal Reserve notes. Now, from that point forward, case law has stated the one could no longer pay a debt that could not merely discharge the debt. One could no longer pay a debt, but they could discharge the debt. I'll say that again. One could not pay a debt, but they could discharge the debt. Once a debt was discharged by tendering Federal Reserve notes, the nature of the debt had changed, and that is no longer collectible. But the debt still exists. Let me give you an example of what I'm talking about. Let's assume that I owed Kadar $2. I don't have any real money to pay Kadar $2 that I owed him. So I asked Kadar if he would agree to let me give him an IOU for the $2. And since Kadar agreed to accept my IOU, he could no longer try to collect the original $2 from me because I discharged the debt with my IOU, known as a Federal Reserve note. But all total, I have created $4 of debt on an accounting ledger. See, the original $2 of debt, which was never paid, plus the $2 I owe you, which is another debt, I have a total of $4 debt that I owe Kadar. And so once one comprehends that under the new system of debt instruments, fiat currency, that the only way new money comes into circulation is that it must be borrowed from the international bankers through the Federal Reserve System, which is bondage upon the people, which is nothing more than borrowing debts to repay debts. That system is an ever-increasing system of bondage, which mathematically is impossible to escape from unless you have right knowledge. Do you understand? So the profits from all registered things had to be put into a constructive trust for the benefit of the owners. And the presumption is if the profits were put into this general fund of the United States and not into the trust for the owners, the scheme would represent fraud. The profits for each owner could not be cum laude, a breach of the fiduciary duty, right? If the owner failed to use the available remedy, which is his fictional credit held in the constructed trust account, the fund, or the financial ledger to literally benefit from the profits, it would not be the fault of the deceivers. It is the owner that failed to learn the law that would open the door to his or her remedy. It would not be the fault of the deceivers. The owner is responsible for learning the law so that one ends the profits from the things that are available to him or her to discharge the debts brought against the public person by the United States Corporation. Do you understand, John Boone? Do you understand? This is why I tell people that the remedies are all in Kahan Tazadaq's book. Which book? Get all of them.